Craig here from North 49. And at times, do you second guess yourself when assessing gaze evoked nystagmus, not sure what you're seeing? Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. In this video, we'll review how to take some steps to reduce the chance of false positive and how to differentiate gaze evoked nystagmus from endpoint physiological nystagmus. So if looking for a gaze evoked nystagmus, it's important to differentiate it from endpoint physiological nystagmus, as endpoint physiological nystagmus is just a normal finding. Whereas gaze evoked nystagmus is indicative of either a central or a peripheral vestibular problem. So some steps to differentiate between the two and reduce the chance of a false setup. Well, first thing, or a chance of a false positive. Well, first thing is making sure that you take glasses off of your patient. Because when you have them look at a target, they may lose the target in the rims of their glasses. And then they'll be looking for their eyes, and that could cause a false positive. So have the patient take their glasses off. Second thing in setup is when you have them look at a target, take it to only about 30 degrees laterally, right? So it's about shoulder level. Right? If you take it too far, more chance of getting that endpoint physiological nystagmus. That being said, some healthy individuals, you will see endpoint physiological nystagmus at 30 degrees and even less. So the third thing to consider with differentiating between gaze evoked nystagmus and endpoint physiological nystagmus is what the nystagmus looks like. With endpoint physiological nystagmus, the nystagmus is not sustained. It comes, it goes, it's variable. Whereas with gaze evoked nystagmus, it's steady. Okay, it's sustained. And with endpoint physiological nystagmus, the nystagmus is typically low amplitude, low velocity. So it's not as obvious as the gaze evoked nystagmus. So let's look at a video here and see if we can tease out, is this endpoint physiological nystagmus or is it gaze evoked nystagmus? So here the patient's looking to their left. You can see it's quite obvious left beat nystagmus and it's sustained. You have to hold it for at least 4 seconds, okay? And make sure they're not blinking during that time, okay? And then hold it, looking to their right, it's sustained, high velocity, high amplitude. And then actually with this individual, we open up the eyepiece. You can see the pupils constrict here. When they look to the left again, you can see that it's quite obvious, sustained. When they look to the right, same deal. So this person actually has direction changing nystagmus, which is indicative of a central vestibular disorder. So there you go. Just some tips to help you differentiate endpoint physiological nystagmus from gaze evoked nystagmus. Remember the setup, how far you go, and with endpoint physiological nystagmus, it's unsustained, low amplitude, low velocity. If you'd like to see some further videos of nystagmus, feel free to check out our website at courses.north49therapy.com. There we have a whole vestibular ocular library. And while you're there, feel free to check out our other educational opportunities and sign up for a free monthly email that goes over strategies to improve your understanding of vestibular therapy and ability to market it and take it to the next level. So I hope you liked this video. And if you did like it, subscribe it. And we look forward to seeing you again. Take care.